I'm going to go to the next slide. but they were told to give up their idol worship. Instead, that's the blind and now the God was an idol worshiper. The elements that were placed inside of the Kaaba was brought in by the blind and now the God. That's what they claimed. The concept of stars being God, the concept of eating place, to the God of Allah, because this is what they were thinking. This is what they are thinking. So the concept of faith and gospel, that was a question for it, that was given for it, instead, that was brought, and it was brought in different aspects of it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the end to that, and that is what Allah taught them in the Messiah. He was not of those who were so true to the Holy One of Allah. He was not of those who associated to the Holy One of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, he was his wife. And then, not only that, but he goes on to praise the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam. Kafir ibn al-Rumi. He was grateful to Allah for his favor that he bestowed upon him. This is about what Allah has chosen him. Ramadan ibn al-Rumi was accepted and guided him to the straight path. Not only that, Allah gave him the goodness of the dunya, and he will be amongst the righteous in the Akhirah. Instead of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I said, he prays for the Prophet and says that we have inspired you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that you will follow the willingness of the wisdom of the Quranic alayhi wa sallam. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was commanded, he was directed to follow the wisdom of the wisdom, the method, and the manhaj of the Quranic alayhi wa sallam. So, we follow him in Tawheed. We follow him in Dawah. We follow him in Sha'ar. In doing these things, right? When we perform prayer, this is what? This is from the Sha'ar of Ibrahim alayhi salam. This is from the practices of Ibrahim alayhi salam. In doing these things, when we make sacrifice and fulfill, this is from the Sha'ar of Ibrahim alayhi salam, it's from the practices of the Prophet alayhi salam. That is why when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed the Sahaba to make Hujj and sacrifice, they asked, Ya Rasulullah, my father is Ibrahim, what is this sacrifice? Where did this originate? Where did this come from? So what is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying? He said, it is the sunnah of your father, Ibrahim alayhi wa sallam. Ibrahim alayhi wa sallam, he struggled so much in the time of the Prophet. He was tested again and again, one test coming, one after the other. And you know that, right? When he became old, extremely old, he had another son. This life of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi has to be a Salikum, that Allah grant me the righteous pious offspring. And I say, for the Salam of the Quran is saying, we have given him the opportunity of our forbearing son. And when that son reached the age of walking and talking and relating with the father Ibrahim alayhi salam, what happens? When the prophets, when they see the dream, when they see the dream that they have a vision, right? Dreams. It's not just a dream, but it's the hukum of Allah, it's the command of Allah. It's the way, it's the revelation for them. So, you know what? Allah is commanding him to sacrifice his son. So what do you say about this? what's your take on this? What do you think? You said, tell us about this time in my life, my son, the only thing you tell is loving the Lord before my father. Do as you are commanded. He said, do as you are, but that is the principle of it, the command of Allah. That the people who shall love in the Father, you will find amongst those who have suffered and teaching. Father, the Son was just like a father. And he received a sacrifice. Allah is Falamma Aslama, whatever he has to be. When they both submitted, and when he laid him on the ground, and when he started to, set his throat, Allah wanted to see whether he would fulfill this written on it. Allah is the perfect idea. When God is in your house, fulfill this written. If not, Allah is an excellent master. This is how you will go to work. When we are sacrificing an animal, what we are really doing is we are sacrificing our self. We are sacrificing our love, our self. In the same way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, I'm ready to sacrifice myself. In the same way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants, we give it to the poor. We give it to those who are in need. We need to receive from them. But what goes for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what Allah wants, goes for the poor of our hearts. The piety, the sincerity, that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. So, when we sacrifice, what we're doing is we're sacrificing our desire and we think of Allah, I'm ready to sacrifice my love, my desire. our Father who dwells in the midst of us today, who sacrificed everything for the sake of the love of God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.